80s and the 70s, you and me, holding hands, talking family. That southern thing I like. You got that southern stuff I like. It's like after school, feeling hard, complimenting you.
Hey, what's up, y'all, man? My name is Whisper Dog, aka Ice Heart, VIP, Broken in Pieces. And this right here, man, I've been waiting to do this one. This is called Sex Time. Time has a position like sex, so what time is it? As I look into the eyes of my diamond, I'm missing. Locked lips and locked new smiles, we pause kissing. I put on her feet as the clock loses its position. Her body goes to 7 and she leans to the dresser. I smile eternally as I begin to undress her. Flew past 8, 9, 9 on the dot. I listen to her moan as I stroke in the spot. She sits up a little, now it's 10 o'clock. A little more for 11, make her feel like she's in heaven. 12's a little harder because I'm holding all the weight. She looks kind of funny with all the stresses on her face. 1 o'clock, 9. I gotta lean on the wall. 2 o'clock now, I gotta catch it before she fall. 3 o'clock's in the bathroom, holding on a towel rack. Get rough for a minute, get her booty a little smack. 60 minutes pass, clearly this foe. While she gets freaky as she ride from the flow. She move her head closer to my body. Now it's 5, I look off to the side, a glimpse of her eyes. There's a clock's in the bedroom, smell each other's feet. At first it's kinda weird, but then we caught the beat. Orgasm time, now how we gonna do this? Obviously 69 and taste each other's juices. Once we got through, we got horny again, so we started start over, but this time in the den. Deuces.
My name is Lynn, this poem is called Poetry Hotline. Hello, operator, what is your name? Wonder if you'd like to play my poetry game. See, I want you to scream loud, go wild, cause I like it when you speak the truth. Give it to me raw, no need for protection, free expression in our private poetry session. I want you to tease me with your rhymes and words, ooh, wrap me in your nouns and verbs. Play with me with your lyrics and song, and maybe, just maybe, I might want to sing along. Kiss me with your intense metaphors. When you feel I am done, make me scream for more. I want to be intertwined in your poem's core. Every declaration I want to explore. Operator, please, give me what I need. Caress me in your sexy similes and soft sentences. Intrigue me with your masculine emphasis. Can you satisfy me with your synonyms? Have me fiending for your phrases, antonyms so vivacious. Please, give it to me like never before. I bust all over my weight. Slow down, this is going too fast. Be gentle and deliver this poem with confidence and sass. Yeah, that's just the way I like it, and I'm glad I called. Thank you, operator, that was so fine. Happy to have called the Poetry Hotline.
man. It's your boy Whisper right here, and this piece right here is called Intelligence. So, who's smart?
Whisper. I actually go to this school. My name is Whisper. I go to Youthville. I represent Youthville Poetry Collective. And I got some of my stuff though. This one right here is called Intelligence. So, who's smart?
The wise or intellectual person would respond. Actions speak louder than words, even though my verbs tend to be a complete belie at times, so.
The smart, wise, or intellectual person wouldn't respond. Actions speak louder than words, even though my verbs tend to be a complete belie at times.
I'd rather look at that question as rhetorical. The intellectual tends to analyze and learn rather than memorize and look at themselves before they criticize, so.
I'd rather look at that question as rhetorical. The intellectual tends to analyze and learn rather than memorize and look at themselves before they criticize. Who's smart?
You say you know, but you don't.
You say you know, but you don't. Funny how it conveniently slips your mind just in the nick of time to save your friend's hide, and it's no surprise you say you're smart. Loudmouth reveals their weaknesses in the quiet type, unnoticed by witnesses, so what the business is. Who's smart?
I conveniently slip your mind just in the nick of time to save your friend's hide, and it's no surprise you say you're smart. Loudmouth reveals their weaknesses in the quiet type, unnoticed by witnesses, so what the business is. Who's smart?
Why everything that's supposed to be bad make me feel so good? Everything they told me not to is exactly what I would. Man, I try to stop, man.
I want to hear all this. I kill you, yo. I take your mama life. Like, I want to hear some soulful music, real music that's got a message to it. Cause like a lot of music nowadays is missing a message.
My inspiration comes everywhere, man. Just performing tonight, that I can get a million ideas off of that. Mm-hmm. Just being around this good vibe of people, inspiration from my people, like my boy Isaiah the Prophet, Ameer, my boy Flo King, you know, it's a lot of people I get inspiration.
So what do you have to say for those individuals your age that seem to just make excuses, you know, in...
People that make excuses, I have to say they have to grow up. This is a new day, like you can't be making excuses your whole life.
Right.
We make excuses your whole life, you're gonna be missing out on opportunity.
As I stand on my block, I know I must move on. The thug says there's no help from this tall, rich church. The church said that this thug joining our church just won't work.
She's an urban black queen, who's a fiend of seeing her face on Hollywood screen. But as I look at the story of her life, I see another scene. She was raised by a single mother, who thought men were the scum that was placed under. So she raised her daughter to not depend on another brother. He taught her to strive for education, change the population, and don't become a part of the statistic information.
Isaiah the Prophet, aka Secret Society, aka Wisdom. And the poetry piece that I'm about to spit today is called My Future Child. The motivation of writing this piece is, I don't have any children, but I always wonder what type of person would I be, or what type of person would my kids be as they get older. These are the type of things that some of us don't think about, because some of us think having children is a fairy tale. Some of us don't think about certain situations. Some of us don't think about being financially stable. being structured mentally. We need to think about these things. So I'm about to have y'all just run through my mind of what I think.
But sometimes poverty is just so quick to point the blame. We won't work, but we want cops say y'all do the same thing too, Isaiah. So chill and take a breather. Because if you don't feel my pain, then I won't feel yours either.
One, two, in case one, stay out of trouble, stay in school. And young lady, that's one I want to stress to you all, like the difference between television and real life. I know a lot of rappers, a lot of entertainers, you know what I'm saying, just to make themselves seem cool. They only give you one side of life, you know what I'm saying? Life is, as you can see, you know, my album is entitled T.I. versus T.I.P. And basically that would be two sides of life, you know, attempting to coexist. One side of life would be...
Hi, my name is Taylor, and the piece I'm doing is called Silence. Even in silence, our love tells a story of hate, hurt, and pain, foreshadowing the later effects of the song of faith and trust, which is simultaneously being sung. Assisted by beats of distorted passion, with the chorus of violence opportunities blasting through the speakers in our chests, no matter where we are, the music of love takes over as we dance as if we are face to face, though we're many miles apart. But our song quickly falls from the number one spot as our beats, which were ever so beautifully orchestrated apart, come together. We learn we are nothing more than a discordance. Now we stand face to face, reminiscing over our temporary strong song happiness, realizing that we fell in love with the song without taking the time to learn the words. And the music stops as if it had never begun, yet still the story continues.
Stacks on the stage when she danced, giving her that high every night, crashing at the sight of those red blue lights as she pleases him to get her fixed so that her palms will stop itching. Itching becomes claustrophobia as she sits in a 10 by 12 all by herself, still fiending. Prepping cast since the first time she had it, a savage she's mad at has officially become her addiction.
Gives me the momentum to do, like, know what they doing. Like, if you go in the, like, when you went in the studio that one time, and you're like, man, oh, I need a hook. I like.
When I turn a party out, four hands is in the air. Some states chill, New York throw chairs.
Trying to erase words rather than the circumstances that bring them into existence.
That's right.
Whereas breakbeats have been the missing link connecting the diaspora community to its drum-oven past. Whereas the quantized drummers allow the whirling mathematicians to calculate the ever-changing distance between rock and stardom. Whereas the velocity of spinning vinyl cross-faded, spun backwards, and re-released at the same given moment that recorded history, yet at a different moment in time's continuum, has allowed history to catch up with the present. We do hereby declare reality unkept by the changing standards of dialogue. Statements such as, keep it real.
Coming to you loud and clear. Like the brain, everyone's attention.
Just to get by. It's funny, when I heard the word of her, soon after into the heart of my life, she came. To my family, friends, and even total strangers, I'm compelled to share her fame, mat and frame the beauty and sound and vibrations of speaking her name. Her aim is my passion, she's my motivation and drive. I'm reminded by the truest of friends, she keeps me alive. Will I die for her? She is the reason I will. In the name of her, so much blood is being spilled. She is my spirit of excellence.
I have dreams of better days, but just like the sea, it never lays down. Ripping and running here and there, making my way all over town. I know mama taught me better than this, but I got myself in a pretty big mess that no one could fix but I. When I seen the newborn, the look in her eyes, I know I had to provide. Selling this and selling that, but it's too late to take that night back. She looked so lovely, but 9 months later, I never thought she'd be having my baby. We were just little kids fooling around, trying to see what the rave was about. Should've used the condom, didn't know that then. I made a mistake I'll never make again. I missed the days playing ball on the court, but now she got me paying child support. Maybe if I sell this little bit of dope, it'll give this baby a little bit of hope. Seeing as though how it has no future, going to the store, be lucky if a nigga don't shoot you. Never had a daddy to show me the way on how to act towards my own one day. Gotta provide, gotta be a man, gotta take care of my responsibilities any way that I can. The anger, the joy, the love, and the pride of knowing that the one that I made was the one that survived.
My life's at a fast tempo. I'm trying to stay on beat. But there's so many obstacles that assist in my defeat. The sounds of the streets always capture my attention. A different genre of people in every place I'm present. Shut up and listen. I thank my mother for the preparation of me. She made me the instrumental of Whisper, Iced Heart, VIP. She taught me how to react to things, how to let some stuff slide. If every hood is an artist, I swear I always vibe to the different melodies of every sound possible. Press skip for some of these hard to overcome obstacles. I ain't done yet. Any male, unless you really are a father, and you say you are, but time will tell. You got some who comes back and try to shower them in cash, but you can't expect them, your child to call you daddy because you're spoiling their ass. Niggas is stupid. It don't work like that. You have to be there the whole 18 years, feeding us, putting a roof over our heads, and clothes on our back. What gives me the right to speak this? Because I'm a bastard, and I say it with pride. My mama didn't need no nigga by her side. But overall, you niggas is ignorant. You just don't know, you make life harder. So I say, why have a Father's Day when there aren't any fathers?
You know, sometimes we don't recognize our dreams inside our reality. And other times, we're not aware of exactly what's real. You know, we walk around daydreaming. But the sunshine always is. And I
just wanna see my lovely sunshine. Sunshine. I just wanna bring back all my blue sky. Blue sky.
The word, Archie Collector. And I want to do a piece I get to do at the music hall. It's called Depot.
Renegade. Not afraid to go against the grain. I've heard deep poets with a talent you can't even train. They have a mindset close to mine, which they explain artistically. They can flow. flow with the melody or speak so heavenly that they might seduce your brain. Words so heavy, you can't lift them with the crane. These poets are the voice of a devastated city. But please don't take pity because through it all, these poets have stood strong. These poets speak the truth, but are sometimes in the wrong. We are the elite. Lyrics so sweet, they might sweep you off your feet into a pool of knowledge. I go to U Prep Middle, but write like I'm in college. Deep poets can metaphorically move mind, or be in deep conversation with themselves, line after line, desperately trying to convey a message. You think we're a problem, but I know we're a blessing. See, we're better than some schools. Deep poets teach lifelong lessons, accumulating bars from experience, turning it into self-expression. Creative crusaders for true poetry, intelligently composing lyrics, whether it be a haiku or a limerick. Some people are numb. They just can't feel it. Or they like the government, they trying to conceal it. However you spit it, make sure you the realest. Be true to the verses you say. Just cause it rhyme don't make it the way. We gon' keep saying the truth, you can't hold it. Cause by conditions of corruption and greed, we're shaped and molded. You may think I'm ignorant, but I'm a deep poet.
Got the first black family headed to the White House. And as much as that excites me, it also scares me, because we all know that when it comes to all great leaders, America is quick to try and wipe out their blackness. So Obamas, lock your doors at night, because this country will try to creep into your room, embed new DNA, and hide your heritage under your mattress, treat you like actors and actresses, you African Prince you, they will fresh Prince you, turn your aunt the illegal immigrant into the light-skinned Aunt Vivian more relatable to their families, they will try to buy you out by moving you from the south side of Chicago to Bel Air, they will ruin your good times by taking your strong black father off air. Obama, I don't care if you are half white, you won't be half all right until they Jesse Jackson you, on top of Michael Jackson you, bleach your face until it's white enough for dollar bills and still not put you on front of dollar bills, they will kill you, drag your culture through the mud and Emmett Till you, until we no longer recognize the real you, throw away your Kirk Franklin gospel CDs, then to the people reveal you like country, African decontinent you and make you believe you are originally from this country, they will get rid of your soul food, turn your Kool-Aid into iced tea, throw away all your pro-black films by Spike Lee, have you only looking dark at night, see they will turn your Michelle into a Condoleezza Rice, and have you raise your daughters whiter than Nancy Kerrigan. See, they will make you forget that you are proud to be black and just make you proud to be an American, serving the red, white, and blue. America will house nigga you, turn you into an Uncle Ruckus from the Boondocks, make you white enough for news from Foxy. They will switch your sport, turn your basketball court into a golf course. And of course, we all know most niggas from the south side of Chicago don't play golf, but they will have you lost. They will turn your revolution into false promise and resolution, start shooting at your Martin Luther King, and turn your I have into the American dream by any means necessary. They will make your darkness illegal, turn your Black Panther into a bald eagle, your five heartbeats into five horsemen. How you divorcing your pastor because he's not white enough? Right now, America is somewhere writing up a plan to turn you into the man, another don't trust politician, not the first Black president, but a mixed one. So keep a close mirror to not only watch your back, but to watch your Black, because they will try and change your change, but you remember where you came from. Know that the money they will use to try and buy you out is made from the same trees your people used to hang from. Before they try and change you, change them. Put a picture of Harriet Tubman in your living room. Finally give Malcolm X his own day. Play Sam Cooke in the morning. Go to bed listening to Nina Simone at night. Send out Christmas and Kwanzaa cards from the White House. And no matter what you do, never allow America, never allow this country, never allow money to white out you.
In this building when it came down, it was me and his Major Watkins, And so we heard that the police was coming in the next day. But me and Majur, Watkins, his brother, died. But you know, he knew all the jazz musicians. He knew Bird. He knew everybody. He said, "Omar, you got a lot of Bird in you. You got a lot of Charlie Parker in you. You better be careful, man, because you're just as crazy as Charlie Parker." But Majur was deep. But we don't take this motherfucker till the police come for us, man. 329 Clinton Avenue, these white people got out. And you see, this building had the Spanish ceilings and the parquet floors. And we were, at that time, they were just paying $225 a month. But these white people, the people were getting ready to account of. So we in this one building, just me and my Jew, and this, we the only two brothers in this building now, 329 Clinton Avenue. And we had this beautiful bay window, man. I always love that bay window. You can sit in there and look at it and see the moon. So all of a sudden, I'm sitting this, the day before the police came. I'm sitting in this window and I'm looking at the moon. I just said to myself, "This is madness." And that poem just came to me, just like that. And the next day, the police came and threw our ass out that motherfucker.
Hi, my name is Dexter Butler, and the name of this piece is "Bleeding Me." I am injured. I'm not okay, but it doesn't really matter now what they say, 'cause them I'm already dead. Special, different, sick in the head. But who are you to judge me now? It's me, my blood that I'm dumping out. Give me a cut, gush it out. I don't really even care right now. I'm going crazy, I'm insane. Hands getting cramped from playing your game. Scratch popularity, scratch the fame. 'Cause being who you are, you should be ashamed. But I'm not ashamed of me at all. Who said a bird with wings you can't fall? You were never really on top at all. Your level of status just stopped and stalled. See, I don't care if I'm dead to you. The only thing live is my deadly views. I'm bleeding me and that's deadly news. 'Cause being like you, I'm sure to lose. I'm never gonna stop my racing, aiming, taming my own mental domain, and I'm never gonna take that strain again. Forget waiting in line, I'm racing in. Let me give you that food for thought. This that food that you never bought. This that ball that you never caught. This that knowledge that you never saw. I'll never conform to how you want me to. I'll never view what you want me to see. The doctor said I should live in what I believe. Now I'm never gonna die because I'm bleeding me.
I won't, I will not, I cannot love you to death. My heart crumbles into a million pieces when I see this happening. An addiction causing an infliction between your heart and your mind. You and it. Lights, camera, and action, and they're flashing, and you're injecting, and I'm expecting you to stop, but with each pop of that rubber band, all I can feel was my mother's glands, bursting with sweat, then bursting with pain, and tears in her eyes, then death in the veins. Mama, mother, ma, this is not an accident, and the fact is this. You are dying in your own arms, and I will not let this consume you, 'cause I'm losing my mind, 'cause I'm not ready to lose you. And this got me walking on pins and needles, 'cause you keep injecting your skin with needles, and it's been happening since I was like 10 with needles, so you gonna have to choose between your kid and needles. 'Cause I can't stand another morning where you wake up yawning and you wake up storming out in kicks to go get you a fix, and you know why your code name is Fix for Smoking? 'Cause it is hard as it is to admit, you are trying to fix what is broken. And this drug is a monster and the worst way to Loch Ness. And I cannot continue this process of you telling me that this is God's fight, when in you I see the dimming of God's light. 'Cause you keep on changing like stoplights until one day you wake up and there is not light. So if this is your path, then go down it. But you cannot expect me to come round it, 'cause I feel death close in your heart whenever I'm around it. So this is my plea. This is all I have left. Please stop this, because I can't, I cannot, I will not love you to death.
If you're listening, yo, 1-2. This one here goes out to, if you're listening,
my man Pookie.
This one goes out to Tamiko. If you're listening, all those who passed away, my aunt Bertha. Yeah, we go round and round, it's just a moment in time.
Good
and
bad.
We go round and round, life is just a moment in time. And we go
round and round, life is just a moment in time. And we go round and round, life is just a moment in time.
I recall being 3 when
when Sonny passed away. One of the greatest in my eyes till this very day. Too young to understand, but understood the ways of good and evil, life and death was in the breath of time. Fate and God only knows what kept Peggy straight. Cause in the very next year, my aunt Dorothy was the lady. More beautiful than the word, it was like killing a mockingbird. She was so young, like the new year was all you heard. I almost saw it so clear, the good times that we had. When my mama showed me pictures, life wasn't so bad. I got babysat by Pat when Beatty was a small guy. And in our cousin's eyes, we were both small flies. Dazzy Wazzy's growing up to be a big girl now. Father figure understands a man might like a profile. I let it sink in a while and told her, let him like your style. But you and Ebony, I'd be damned if this short life ain't heavenly. Peace and harmony, family season. And it goes. Now this one goes out to those who passed away far too young. So we say,
life is just a moment in time.
Time is just a phase. Life is just a risk. This one goes out to my man David.
Life is just a moment in time.
Just recently left us.
Life is just a moment in time.
God we trust.
Life is just a moment.
Young to the old. Yeah.